This material is intended for general informational purposes only and does not constitute legal advice. The law varies by jurisdiction and is constantly changing. For legal advice, you should consult a lawyer that can apply the appropriate law to the facts in your case.
Aloha, I'm Coralie Chun Matayoshi, and welcome to my legal podcast, What's the Law? Each week, you will learn valuable information about various legal topics to help you get through life's ups and downs, and even when things go sideways. Now with me is Steven Guttman. He's a partner in the law firm of Kester, Umebayashi, Bain, and Matsunaga. He's the past president and director of the Hawaii State Bar Association Bankruptcy Law Section and current president and director of the Collections Law Section. Steven's law practice focuses on bankruptcy, business, and real estate, and he's been recognized as one of Hawaii's super lawyers for many, many years. Welcome, Steven.
Thank you for inviting me.
So one of the most common reasons that individuals file for bankruptcy is that they get hit with a serious illness and they can't pay their medical bills, or they lose their job and can't find other employment. The pandemic has caused so many of people to lose their jobs or businesses, and as bills mount, some are considering filing for bankruptcy. Tell me, what is bankruptcy?
Well, bankruptcy is a legal proceeding by which the individual is able to address their debt through either a variety of different types of bankruptcies that will allow them to get on with their life and have a fresh start.
And what are the advantages of filing for bankruptcy besides getting rid of some of your debt?
Does it stop creditors from
going after you?
Right. Anytime you file for bankruptcy, there's what they call an automatic stay that is operable at the time of the filing. And the automatic stay means that any legal proceedings that are pending go on hold. And to the extent somebody is having a wage garnishment, that will cease because of the bankruptcy filing. If there's a foreclosure and an auction is scheduled, the auction will go off the calendar. And if there's an automobile that you're concerned about being repossessed, you don't have to worry about that, at least while the bankruptcy is pending.
Utilities can't get cut off either, right?
Right. All creditor action gets placed on hold. It won't stop any criminal action. If you got that problem, but in terms of any type of regular legal proceedings, civil proceedings, they go on hold.
And what are some of the disadvantages?
Well, the main disadvantage is that the filing is on a credit report for 10 years. Mm. So the usual timelines for what becomes outdated information on a credit report gets extended by the as to a bankruptcy filing. Though I should note that sometimes people's credit is so bad that the score actually goes up after they file.
Oh, that's not so good. So what is also public, right? When you file
that's the other disadvantage. You do with every bankruptcy filing, you are giving very detailed information regarding assets, debt, and information that normally would not be known to any third party, but is a public document by virtue of the bankruptcy filing.
Right. So what kind of bankruptcy filings are there? There's Chapter 7 and 11 and 13. What's the difference?
Well, Chapter 7 is the traditional bankruptcy. When people talk about bankruptcy, that's usually what they're talking about. Mm-hmm. It is what they call the liquidation chapter, though in point in fact, for most individuals who file for bankruptcy, their property is exempt and nothing gets liquidated. But the Chapter 7 is a fast-track system that from time of filing and the creditors meeting and completion, and not much more than 90 days, you're in and out and done.
And your assets get liquidated and given to the creditors to satisfy your debts.
If there is assets that are not exempt.
Mm-hmm. Correct. We'll get back to that later. What about Chapter 11 and 13?
Well, Chapter 13 and 11 are both reorganization chapters.
Okay.
11 is for a business. But if you're an individual owning real property, you would qualify for Chapter 11. And in this state, because of the price of real estate,
that's true.
There are a lot of people some people are forced into a Chapter 11 scenario as opposed to the Chapter 13, because there's debt limits on Chapter 13. Mm-hmm. Those debt limits make sense for most of the United States, but they...
Not for Hawaii.
Not for Hawaii. the 13 is a 3 to 5 year repayment plan.
Okay.
Not necessarily full payment, but if you have a cash flow that you have the ability to pay 50 cents on the dollar over the 3 to 5 years, then that's what you would pay. And then the remaining 50 cents on the dollar would get discharged just as it would in a Chapter 7 after you complete the Chapter 13 plan.
Right. So it just gives you a chance to reorganize and try to pay and keep all of your assets.
Right. And that's one of the reasons why people will do a Chapter 13 is mm-hmm. they may have some assets that are not exempt and right. like a home and they don't mm-hmm. want to move. So
right.
the 13 may be the viable option. I should state for the record that I am the attorney for the Chapter 13 trustee.
Okay. So will the bankruptcy discharge wipe out all of my debts? Are there some that you still have to pay?
There's some that if you have them, you're still going to have to pay them. The three major categories are certain types of taxes. If, for example, you were an employer and had fiduciary taxes, such as Social Security taxes, mm-hmm. those never get discharged. Mm-hmm. If it's income tax or excise tax, and it's less than 3 years old, you're not going to have that discharged. If it's old enough, past the 3 years, mm-hmm. then it gets discharged. Mm-hmm. Another big category is student loans. Mm-hmm. There is a certain, if you're extreme hardship, not the just the usual hardship that caused the bankruptcy, but a situation where you've got now say a medical condition that's never going to get better, and you're never going to be able to earn the income, you may be able to discharge the student loan. But for the majority of people, the large majority of people, the student loan is not a dischargeable debt. Mm-hmm. The third big category is alimony and child support. That is never dischargeable.
Can't get away from that, right?
Can't get away from that.
And also fines and penalties like traffic tickets and DUI, you still have to pay that, right?
Right. You still have to pay that. And related to the DUI, if you got into an automobile accident and you were found to be have been drunk as part of it, that judgment is not dischargeable in mm-hmm. the bankruptcy. Nor is a fraud. The debt was incurred by fraud because you gave
right.
false financials.
Right.
Right. Right.
So what kind of personal property can you keep?
Well, for most people, are able to keep virtually all their personal property. There's both federal and state exemptions, and you have to choose one or the other. You can't
mix and match.
Right. And as to which one you use, that depends upon the particular individual's situation. Mm-hmm. For most people, they will use the federal exemption because there's a catch-all that is a little over $12,000. It gets changed every couple of years for inflation, so it's always an odd number.
And that's like for jewelry and clothing and other necessities.
Furniture.
Appliances.
Yes, it's basically any type of personal property. And you're looking at value is as to if you had, for example, a garage sale, what could you sell the property for? Mm-hmm. So it's not a depreciated value. It's not replacement mm-hmm. value. Mm-hmm. It's not the original value. It is what can you get for today? And most... you can have some very expensive clothing, but try to sell it as used. I mean, the value goes down, and that's true for furniture, TVs, computers, all kinds of electronic stuff.
So the idea of bankruptcy is not to just take everything away. You need some things, including tools of the trade. Tell me what tools of the trade is.
Well, if it's a carpenter, for example, it's the basic stuff like the hammer and the saw and whatever you need to in order to do your profession. Mm. If you're a fisherman and you own and you have a boat, well, first off, your rod and reel are part of your tools of trade. Mm-hmm. But actually, under state law, even the fishing boat can be exempt.
Right.
So that's one of the reasons why you should be speaking with an attorney to figure out what type of whether you use the federal or the state, and which ones mm-hmm. are appropriate and how to maximize, so that you when you have the fresh start, you mm-hmm. actually have done so with keeping what the law allows you to keep.
Right. What about a home or car? Can you tell me about the homestead exemption? I know that in Hawaii, if you're the head of household or over 65, you get a $30,000 exemption. What is an exemption?
Exemption is the amount of money if the property was sold that a creditor, who's not a lender, okay. The mortgage holder. Uh-huh. So for any involuntary type of a lien, you would get to keep before that, say, credit card judgment creditor mm-hmm. gets paid.
So you still have to pay your mortgage though, right? Even when you go bankrupt.
Right, if you want to keep the home, you're going to have to keep paying the mortgage, or if you have mm-hmm. a car loan and you want to keep the car, mm-hmm. you're going to have to keep making the car. Mm-hmm. If there is an arrearage that's owed on the car or the mortgage, I mean, that's one of the reasons why you would use a Chapter 13, because that would allow you to address the arrearage mm. over the 3 to 5 year time period of a Chapter 13.
Right.
And at the end of the day, then keep
right.
the
then
home.
You can keep it. So you pay a little bit of the back, and then you keep going forward with the payments that you need to pay, and then you get to keep the property.
Right.
Right. Can you own anything after you go bankrupt?
Oh, yes. yeah. I mean, basically, the bankruptcy is taking a snapshot with a historical lens of what your financial situation is at the time of filing. Mm-hmm. And with the major exception of an inheritance within 6 months, okay. virtually everything else you get to keep. It's all new because it's post-bankruptcy.
Okay. And how often can you file for bankruptcy?
Well, a traditional Chapter 7 bankruptcy, you can file every 7 years. It goes back to the biblical Deuteronomy 15:1, which talks about people getting a fresh start after 7 years. Mm-hmm. So it's the same idea.
Well, that's a wrap. I just want to thank Steven Guttman for his time and expertise. And thank you for joining us on What's the Law. Until next time, ahui ho.